suing is an issue that's been in and out of court for years, and now the federal government is suing St. Bernard Parish for discrimination. The feds say it's been going on there since Hurricane Katrina. WDSU anchor Rachel Wolf is live in the parish with a document filed late this evening. And Rachel, what is the genesis of this lawsuit?
Well, this Norman, this lawsuit stems from a number of complaints filed by one local nonprofit. At issue is the way that houses are rented here. That process, and the federal government and this local nonprofit say that process blocks people of color from finding housing here. The Department of Justice filed this lawsuit in federal court Tuesday after 10 complaints from the Greater New Orleans Fair Housing Action Center over St. Bernard's permissive use permit process.
If you have a property and you want to rent, then you have to pay a $250 fee and apply for a permit to rent the property. And if anyone else is if anyone else already has a permit within 500 feet of your property, then you cannot get a permit. And so the thing that happens is that neighbors know that someone wants to rent a property, and so they will purposefully apply for a permit without any intention of using the permit.
James Perry, who runs the nonprofit, says that's what happened to an interracial couple in 2008 when they tried to move into one St. Bernard neighborhood. It led to an investigation by HUD.
They're all based on this idea that the permissive use permit process, a process used to allow people to rent their properties, has been used in a discriminatory fashion, and it's kept people of color out of housing in St. Bernard Parish.
Last year, former parish president Craig DeFerro issued a stop work order at the mixed income housing developments, refusing to follow a federal judge's orders to allow Provident Realty to move forward, even after she deemed similar moves racially discriminatory in the past.
The developers have misused race as a screen to shield their own singular motive of profit at the expense of a recovering community. What we have been forced to accept is a systematic stripping of local governing authority.
DeFerro insisted it was unconstitutional for the courts to interfere and that the apartments would negatively impact the housing market. In the end, the project was approved, but not before the parish had paid tens of thousands of dollars a day in fines and legal fees. Perry hopes new parish president David Peralta will mean a step in the right direction.
We're hopeful that the new leadership in St. Bernard Parish, once they have a chance to look into this issue, will do the right thing.
So we actually did get a comment from David Peralta tonight. He said that he just received the lawsuit and wants the chance to go over it with the parish attorney before he makes a statement. Live on your side in Chalmette, Rachel Wolf, WDSU News.
All right, Rachel, thank you. The Greater New Orleans Fair Housing Action Center also plans to file a separate lawsuit over this issue.